大家好，欢迎收听今天的早安英文，我是卡拉。
Hello, welcome to Morning English。早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
And I'm Joseph. Hey, Kara. Today I wanted to tell you about a word that I recently learned actually means something different than I believed it to mean.
What's that?
Chauvinism. I originally believed it to mean the idea of belittling women.
And it's not? I thought it meant that too. And I've heard it many times on movies and TV shows.
Well, actually, it means an irrational belief in the superiority or dominance of one's own group or people.
好，这个开场听起来有点复杂啊。首先呢，重复一下我们刚刚提到那个关键词叫做 chauvinism， 它的拼写呢是 chauvinism。那这个词呢，一开始啊，我和 Joseph 我们都以为它是针对女性的，但其实呢，这个词最本身的意思是极端的、不合理的，或者说过分的、盲目的热爱自己所处的这个团体。那为什么呢 ？Why did we both believe it was against women?
Well, in American English, when someone uses the word chauvinism or a chauvinist, it's shorthand for male chauvinism, which by using the adjective male before the word, it changes the meaning to an irrational belief in the superiority or dominance of men.
Okay, I see.所以呢，就是因为在美式英文当中，如果有人讲这个 chauvinism， 或者讲这个 chauvinist， 当然这个 nist 就是指这种人啊。如果说讲到这个的话呢，通常他们其实是 male chauvinism 的一个缩写，或者说一个更加方便、更加简单的说法。那当然，这个 male chauvinism 它的意思呢，就是这个大男子主义，就是男生，就是男人们认为自己所处的这个团体，也就是男性团体，比另外一个团体，女性团体更加优越一些。所以呢，慢慢的，如果我们单独听到 chauvinism 这个词呢，也会认为说它是对女性的一种歧视，认为是大男子主义。And speaking of this idea, it reminds me of some words that I wanted to ask about, but didn't know how to bring this topic up without sounding strange and uncomfortable. So I guess now is the best time.
Okay, well, now you're making me a little bit nervous.
Yeah, and here it goes.
Okay.
今天呢，就要和大家聊一些就是歧视女性的一些英文词汇。那因为呢，最近啊，不只是一次出现过一些有人在公开场合说一些带有偏见的这个词汇，所以呢，我们今天要教给大家这些词呢，并不是说要教大家去用，而是说当你在见到这些词的时候，你要知道它们是什么意思。所以呢 ，don't use them. Just like wherever you see them, you should know what they are. 那首先第一个词 ，since it's winter time, I wanted to ask about the word frigid.
Okay, well, such a weighted question. I feel slightly uncomfortable talking about this word. So, first of all, your relation between winter and frigid is a good relation because frigid does mean very cold, like frozen. Like, you could say frigid air.
就是这个词本身的含义呢是冰冷的，或者说结冰的。比如说你可以讲冰冷的空气 frigid air.
Or it can also mean not showing any feelings of friendship or kindness.
就是 like distant, 就是指情感上的冷淡、冷冰冰的。比如说这个 frigid voice, 就是冷冰冰的声音。但是它那个 offensive 的含义是什么？
Right, so when we use this word, usually it's to describe a woman and we're talking about her desires. By saying that, it means that she doesn't have any desire to have fun.
okay. 所以呢就是not being able to enjoy sex. 就是就性冷淡的。
Or maybe just not interested in the idea of it.
Okay. 所以呢就是也许是生理上的甚至是心理上的表示性冷淡，所以呢你可以讲 a frigid woman.
So what is the next uncomfortable word that you will attack me with?
第二个词呢是这个，我觉得这个 sounds slightly better, 叫做 frumpy.
Okay, well, this word, yeah, is much less offensive than your first choice to give me. Frumpy can mean the same thing as maybe unfashionable, homely, or disheveled, depending on how you use it. It can be from unoffensive to just a little offensive.
Frumpy 这个词呢通常都是用来形容女孩子或者说女孩子的穿着非常的过时非常土气非常落伍比如说你可以讲 She looked so frumpy next to those women 就是说和那些女人待在一起她就显得非常的落伍非常过时
So how many more of these words do you have? I'm feeling a little bit like a bad guy giving so many words that are offensive I don't want people to think that I think less of others
大家不会的啦啊，不用担心。
Okay.
所以啊、，Have you noticed you keep me, keep making me say those bad words, and you didn't say them even a single time?
I'm not making you say them. You're bringing them up. It was your idea.
好，开玩笑啊！我相信大家会明白我们的用意的。那下一个词呢是 shrill。
Okay, well, this word doesn't have to describe only women. It simply describes a high-pitched noise.
所以这个词呢但是 men usually tend to have low pitch voice
Right
对所以这个词呢通常用来形容女性尖锐的声音而且即使是有同样就是声音尖锐的男性的话呢基本上大家也不会用这个词来形容他们所以这就是为什么觉得这个词会有点 offensive 那比如说你可以讲 That ugly shrillness in her voice 就说她的嗓音非常的尖利非常刺耳就 给人感觉有点冒犯啊
So since you mentioned that you're the one bringing up these words and I'm afraid I will sound like the bad guy, but you're the one actually using these words in this conversation, I will bring up some words to make you feel less uncomfortable.
Okay, thank
and
you.
And since your words are all thinking about against women kind of words, bimbo is the first word that comes to mind for me.
Bimbo.
Yes.
这个词呢也许大家在美剧里面听到过而且呢它通常用来指那一些 blondes.
Yeah, I would, if you say bimbo, I'm thinking of an attractive blonde person.
对就是一个外貌非常的 attractive, 就是身材非常好然后呢长得非常漂亮的那种金发女郎然后呢又非常的无知这种人呢我们就会管他们叫做 bimbo. 那其实这个词呢是有点歧视的啊是有点性别歧视的含义在里面的。
And if you're talking about a person like this that's making kind of cute but stupid mistakes all the time, you could call them ditzy. This would be the adjective for a bimbo.
所以 bimbo 呢是一个名词我们讲 a bimbo, 然后呢 ditzy,、这个词的拼写是 D-I-T-S-Y, 但是注意不要读成 ditzy,、不要读成 ditzy, 而是 ditzy,、它是一个形容词就是那种傻傻笨笨的。
And the last one to wrap this up on a, you know, I would say positive, but just because it's not against women.
Yeah.
A bad word equal for all people. Airhead.
Airhead.
Right. Your head has no brain inside. It's just empty and full of air.
Air.
Airhead.
如果是我们的话我们会讲你的脑子里面都是 dirt, 都是土。但是英文里面呢会讲 airhead, 就是脑子里面什么都没有就是空气。但是这个词呢就是、男生女生都是通用的。所以呢我们刚刚其实讲的最后这个词是 bimbo 但是呢如果说有同样的含义但是没有太多的性别指向的话呢你可以用 ditzy 或者 airhead 好的感谢大家收听我们今天的节目所以呢我们今天这一期节目就不舒服的节目就和大家聊到这里了最后呢还是给大家重复一遍我们刚刚提到的这几个词第一个是 chauvinism、The second one is
frigid
Okay 第三个呢是 frumpy第四个是
Yeah, the fourth one is shrill.
最后一个是 bimbo. 那对，如果说大家之后再看到这些词呢，心里面要知道啊，这些词是有这个性别歧视、有冒犯含义的，心里面要明白就好了。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容我们都会在这个频道更新我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语如果你觉得还不错的话记得给我们订阅哦另外点开小铃铛这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频了对了如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记在视频简介或者评论区领取哦你也可以给这个视频点赞点赞就相当于自动保存了
And so much for today. 我是卡拉。
And I'm Joseph.
我们下期再见，拜拜。
We'll see you later.